number three for the financial report. Just past the minutes. So hopefully I'll have my copy in the same order as yours. But we do have an outstanding check for Kevin Bailey to sign when I see him next. That is at $11,238.38. Check, and then see what else. Also reflected in the administrative charges page, it shows the legal fees.
Well, we don't have.
No audit fees just yet, and then the administration fees. We have the list of advanced disposal payments for the months of, that will be seen in the management. June, July, August, and September.
Excuse, Robert said if we need to vote on something, then we can call him back. I don't know if he's going to get a call.
He's still agreeing. He would be the fourth member, but we would be five.
Okay, okay, all right, yeah.
Before you get, while you're saying that, it's still in the pandemic, and governor's order does allow you to have these things by telecom.
Yes.
And, I know you have a system that does it. Our law firm has one that the cities and counties are using. Everybody just on the phone. A lot of the bigger jobs are using the name, but everybody's got it.
Okay, yeah.
We can think about for January, definitely.
Yeah, okay. To do that, and maybe that'll help everybody.
Okay.
Especially those that are COVID sensitive.
We could talk about that. That's a good point. Definitely, because I
don't
want to do the revenue dispersion eventually.
Yes, that's right. You vote on the phone every day.
Okay.
Not as good, but it's better than nothing.
So the Georgia Fund 1 statement account is here, and that balance is just over $1.3 million. The current statement within the bank reconciliation is under $250,000, so I believe that is the trigger that would have our financial person move funds over into the Georgia Fund account. But right now it's at $222,252.27. Which is also shown on the public funds interest checking account for Regions Bank. Can y'all hear me okay through the mask? Okay. And I'm sure it sounds muffled. And then we also have the annual financial report, which goes from July 1st of 2020 through the end of October, when Ms. Kelly printed this. And then also the financial report since the inception of the Deep South Solid Waste Authority in 1996. That's everything, Mr. Harvey, for the financial report. Unless there's any questions.
Any questions on the financial report? Once again, we'll have to wait to vote. This was the financial audit engagement letter.
Yes, you should have it in your packet with the heading of the Valenti Rackley CPA firm. And if you have any questions about that, I can ask for you. I probably won't be able to answer them myself, but the fee is on the last page. It says it's $6,250. And we would need the board chair to sign for this. I think if we did a motion on this last year or not.
Yeah, I think we do that every year.
Right.
So that probably something we should put on the agenda for next meeting where we can call the meeting by phone.
Okay.
If we can do it.
Did anyone have any questions or concerns?